Hello, everybody, and welcome. This is Daniel Nguyen from Private Lending Group. And today we're going to talk about the Bird Dog Training for 2017. I'm very excited because there's so many people that have called me. And if you have called and I have not returned your call or you emailed, I apologize. Really, because this is brand new, the way that we're doing it, we're giving the data or the information away for free to certain people. Hoping that that will spark some good things. It's just some new procedures that we're putting into place, and I think we're doing a lot of work internally that will hopefully help you, because this is not just a one-time event for those that are serious or those that want to make some serious money. This is something that we can do for year after year after year. I've been earning money off of tax deals for a very long time. In the past, it was very limited what I could do. I was only lending money, and it wasn't money that I had a say in the final decision. And now in 2016 and now 2017, I'm able to fund these deals. I'm able to flip these deals. I'm able to LLC. I'm able to do all the different things. I'm able to purchase, partner, and fund. So that means that those of you that we're able to do this together with, we have a lot of options on how to help families in Cook County that are in serious, serious situations with these taxes and to be paid for that. And, you know, it's the old Zig Ziglar saying, help enough people get what they want and we will get what we want. So that's really what we're trying to do. Yes, I do like making money, but more importantly, I know that if I add value to the marketplace, some of you people we've already done deals together with, that if I add value in the marketplace, then I should be rewarded or will be rewarded. And sometimes I'm rewarded a lot and sometimes a little. The bottom line is, if you're a baseball player, as long as you get on base and you can score runs, that's what it's all about. Hopefully there's a few Cub fans out there. But I'm getting ready. The Cubs are playing in Las Vegas on Friday and Saturday, and I'm not going to be here. Can't believe it. They finally come here 2 years in a row and I won't be there. So I'll edit that part out. Anyways, let's get started. As you know, and as we talk about, there's really a lot of opportunity in Cook County. There are so many people that are delinquent on their taxes. And the list that we're currently giving you has over 300 people on it. And we're going to go over that list in a second. So here's what we're offering. We're offering loans or partnership options to delinquent property owners. As many of you know, it's still very difficult for a property owner to go get a loan with a bank. If that property owner doesn't have a job, then it's impossible, as you know. And if that property owner is self-employed, pretty much with a bank, it's impossible. And if that property owner has bad credit, these are no-no-nos. So we've come up with a solution. We have a way to say yes to all these situations, provided that the people have a lot of equity in the property, right? I mean, if they have no equity or the property is dilapidated, it has no value, then those are not our deals. And every once in a while, you will call people or you will evaluate assets that are on our list that that's the case. They don't have much value or they don't have enough equity, so we have to pass. But the majority of the leads and the majority of the data that we provide has been sorted, sifted through, and has plenty of equity. So as one of you know, the reason why this is such a great opportunity in Cook County is because Cook County has some of the highest taxes in the country. And I really feel sorry for the people that have these beautiful houses and even people that live in, I mean, I understand you live in Orland Park, you have a $500,000 house, you pay $1,000 a month or Country Club Hills. But some of the people, I'm seeing tax bills in Dalton and Riverdale where people have a four flat and it's only, and they're paying $10,000 a year in property taxes. And that is unfair, and you know, obviously the property owners need to debate and when they go into the tax and they fight for the lower property taxes. They need to do that. They need to get those people on their team. But many of these people are not doing that, and they're in this situation, and hopefully we'll be able to help some of them and educate them going forward. Just to go over this quickly, property owner doesn't pay their taxes. The taxes were just due March 1st. The government needs their money. They need to pay. They need their money. So they sell the property taxes to investors. Investors can earn up to 18% in Illinois for buying these, and they have to buy them for 3 years before they can finally ask a judge and the county to give them the deed to the property. So here's some websites that you're going to want to learn about and use in the future, because I use these every day. And I'm going to show you on the slides next, so I'm not going to just read through them. They're there as a permanent record. Let's go look at some of them. So here's the tax list. And this is just a small screenshot, because really there's a lot more fields. But if you go left to right, you got the input date. And this is a list from last year. This isn't the current list, so just bear with me here. Column B is the property ID number. And most of the property data that you want to look up on the county websites that we're going to go through use the tax ID number. And so that's like the Social Security number. But most of them, you can use the address or the property tax ID number. So it's really important that you know what the property tax ID number is, and that will help you get to this data really quick. So in Cook County, they give you a lot of information. They give you a first name, and if there's a second name, husband and wife, business partners, corporations, whatever. And so they're listed in column C, D, E, and F. If you look all the way to column P, they also have a mail to address. So if somebody doesn't live in that property, then that is the property, like if it was a rental property, that was the forwarding email address that they gave to the county when they did a transfer of deed, or they notified the county to send the tax bills to the mail too. And so you have these two different addresses where you can get a hold of property owners. Column H is the property address. That is the subject property address. That's where we are, how we're going to sort and decide which neighborhoods we're going to go in. Like on this one, you got Robbins, Markham, Tinley, Cicero, Bellwood, Hazelcrest, Homewood, Oaklawn, Lansing. So you can determine which are the properties that you want to go after. Column I, J, K is, you know, city, state, zip. Column L is the property type, residential, condominium, apartment building, vacant land. That's what you'll find in column L. And these columns will be pretty consistent when you open up the real spreadsheet that we're sharing with you. Column M is the date of the sale. And this is very important. You want to sort by the when the properties are coming. You want to go to the ones that are coming up quickest, because those have the shortest fuse. And for those of you that listen, or those of you that remember, I have been very successful with helping people that have went past the redemption date or the date of sale. So if somebody, if you happen to get a hold of somebody, or they call you the day of, the day before, or a week after, it's not over yet. There is still a chance that we can help that property owner. So we still need to collect that data and see if it's somebody we can help. Column N is the lien amount for 1 year only. What I usually do is I take that lien amount and I multiply it by 3 or 4 to figure out what the current tax bill is. So on this example in Cicero, $5,000 times 4, that tax bill is going to be at least $20,000. And I just did one in Cicero at the end of 2016, and the taxes were like $26,000. It was very similar. It wasn't this address. It was another address closer to Cicero Avenue. So there's a lot more data in this list, but this is the primary data that you're going to get. And this is what you could sort by to determine each week what you're going to go after, if you're going to go after this, and how you're going to go after this. Okay, so the next website that you have to know of, and this is what I do, even for loans that we get in here every day, somebody calls me up, and I go to this website and I type in their property address or the PIN. Across the right-hand top with the picture is the top half of the data that you get. And it has the property address, has the mail to person's name, and on the right-hand side, it gives you a value. I don't hold a lot of value. I don't actually take what they value the property at 100%, but it is a starting point to tell you what the county has value the property at. Of course, we need to back it up with comparable data. On the bottom half is really important. That's why I made it the larger portion of the picture, is the tax bill amounts and tax history. And this particular property, it was recently paid. So I wanted to show you that it was paid. But if it was unpaid, on the left-hand side here, 2016, 2015, would show unpaid. And then in the middle screen in the bottom, it says tax sale delinquencies. It shows you that the 2014 taxes were paid by the tax buyer. The 13 were paid by the tax buyer. This one was just paid in January. So it was a Northside property over on Montana and Western, worth probably close to $1 million. So we were pursuing that, and we found out that they got paid. So this is the first thing I do. When you see in the bottom right-hand corner, it says document deeds and liens. At the bottom of it says more record information. What I typically do is I copy and paste the tax ID number up here. Then I click on the record more information. It takes me to this website, ccrd.info. From here, I copy and paste the tax ID number into the search bar, and then I type in the property information or the PIN up here, hit search, and then you get this data over here on the right. So this is actually two different screens. I entered the tax ID number, then they gave me this data. So in this one, you could see right where I'm pointing at that a mortgage was taken out. And the mortgage was taken out. You can click on the word mortgage, and it takes you to this screen. And on the right-hand side, it shows you that the mortgage was taken out for $50,000. If you actually click on the view images here, you can actually view the mortgage and see who the lender was. So this one we missed. We didn't get to, didn't mark it, didn't get to it fast enough. And somebody else actually did a $50,000 loan on $1 million property and helped this family. But these are great tools. Before you go out to properties, you don't have to do a tax search on everyone. But as soon as you talk to people, you actually want to begin looking at the title, because you want to see if they're actually in title. What we have found is that a lot of properties are handed down to one generation to the next because people pass away. And so they're not on title. And the first thing when I'm talking to people, I go to these websites and I want to see that they're on title. If they're not on title, it doesn't mean we can't help them. It just means we know more facts about what needs to get done in order to help these people in the future. So next slide. Actually, okay, there's another website that I'm going to take you to, but we're going to go live in a few seconds here on the internet. So these two are very valuable to get to the ownership. And you also want to make sure there's no open mortgages, because even though we sort this list, as this in the case of this one, when we process this list at the beginning in January, this mortgage wasn't taken out. So as we were marketing it, we went and did another search and saw that it was paid. Especially if you're going to go knocking out on doors, you want to find this, go to this other site I'm going to share with you, because you definitely want to not go knocking on doors if they've already paid their taxes. So the next screen is the final notice. And we posted this final notice on the internet page, our website, so you can make a copy of this, edit it, put your name and phone number on there. When you go knocking on doors, or even if you mail, you could mail this piece. We actually, right on the top, it says that your tax deed is due, property tax is on, and we handwrite in the date right up here. We tell them to call us 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, because we have an answering service. And then we have a web page that they can go to fill out an information. Most people do not go to the website. Most people they get any notice, they just call you. So this is a letter that you can use and modify. It's on our website. Here is another document you could use for once you begin talking to people. You can fill out this information so when you're talking to us, we have I'm just noticing that we have somebody else's phone number and email on there. So ignore that. If you go to our website, the updated version of this is on our website. When you begin talking to people and getting the information, this is what you'll start finding out to make sure if we have a deal or not. If you get really, really motivated, and this is what we use for the paid members of the affiliate program versus the unpaid, is we put all this data in Podio. Podio, you can get a free Podio account even if you're not a paid affiliate, and you could put this data in there, and it helps you organize the data. And it's a free CRM, which is a customer relationship management software. It's a free software, Podio.com. So how this is supposed to work? We are providing you lists of sorted data of people that have little to no mortgage and have lots of equity and lots of value. We're providing you marketing materials, and we're providing you the support for you to go out there and contact these delinquent property owners, and then we can collect the info we need so we can come up with a solution, if a solution is doable, for these people, and then we can partner on these deals. We will prepare all the documents. We will help get the deal funded quickly so everyone gets paid, and then we can go out there and do this again. So let's go to the internet and show you that other website that I wanted to share with you. Okay, so if you've already got the link, if you go to this website, Chicago Rehab Loans /resources/bird-dog-tax-opportunity 0317, you can download the list. Copy of the current list is right here. Decide which property owners you want to work with. Then you can print out the notice. Print out your package for compensation when you're ready. And then verify the properties that you want to, verify the properties whether or not the taxes have been paid. So let's go to David Orr, County Clerk's office, and look at that website real quick. Here, you have to type in a PIN, and let me grab a PIN for you here. Let me use a different property. 1625 200. So on this particular deal, it's showing that it was redeemed on 2/27/17. So what I have been finding, that there's a, you know, maybe 15-20% of the properties are redeeming. And this is why, if you really like a property and you're going to start knocking on the door, you want to come here and go through these and type these in there. Because this one, 227, we're on 223. There's about a 7-day lag period from when the property owner pays the taxes and when it lists there. Let's go look up another one just because I want to show you what it looks like when they're not paid. So there's 7 days between, like, if the guy paid his taxes 7 days ago, it would take about 7 days before it shows up. So you could go knock on a door, and a guy could say, I just paid the taxes yesterday, and it's because they just paid the taxes yesterday, and it didn't show up yet. So let's check out this one here. On this one here, this is what it looks like when they have not paid yet. You could see that the property taxes were sold for 2012, 13, and 14. And it shows that in highlight in red that these property taxes are due. And in this particular one, this is off the real list. These have to be paid by 4/20. That's their drop dead date. So this is a very valuable website. It's Cook County Clerk's Office, and it's a great way for you to not waste your time, basically. So go to our website, chicagorehabloans.com. Go to this link, Bird Dog Tax Opportunity, and all the documents that we're talking about are loaded here free. So if you come in here, download this list. Here, I'll do it for you. You could begin searching what properties. So what I do, this one shows that it's an estate. So we like to look those up and see who the other heirs are. You can see there's 313 in this particular list. Sort it however you want, by zip code, by city, by loan amount, or what do you call it, tax amount. Here's the taxes by property type. Over here you could see that they have the mail to address, which is oftentimes a different address. So the people don't live in the property, subject property address. So you gotta market them to where they live. Here's the tax, name of the tax buyer in this column here. So you're able to do that, download the notice, and begin marketing. So let's go back to here's the Cook County property info. Here's if you want to view the image of the let me do this, pipe in another one, 2029. This one shows there's an order by the city of Chicago. This property's obviously got building code violations against it, dating back to 2014. So what's nice is you can actually go look at this order from the city. Come over here, view images, and there's the order from the city. Boom, order appointing limited general receiver. Anyways, we are excited about getting started. One of the things I was showing you was one of the links. We use Redfin and Trulia for the values. What do you need to do to get started? If you're not an affiliate and you want to become an affiliate, you want us to be able to pull the reports from TLO, which allows us to find the names of the relatives, find the names of people who, if they moved out of town, the other side of town, then become an affiliate. If you want to get started on a free basis, go to this URL and sign up. Go to the webpage, start downloading the information, start emailing in the leads. I don't want to, don't have a lot of time to talk to you right now. Kelly and I are working on a lot of these deals ourselves right now. So, if you want to ask us questions, email is probably the best. And once you get somebody that's interested, as soon as you bring us a good lead, we'll get on the phone with the people. We'll do a three-way. You don't have to try to sell them on anything other than trying to get them an appointment with us, that we have a potential solution. Once we get the deals in writing, we'll be able to then fund the deals. So do you have any questions? Like I said, email me. I'm not trying to sell you on anything. I'm basically looking for partners that can bring me deals. As I stated last week, there's three different levels of partnership. You could just refer a name to us. We sign a deal. We pay you a Bird Dog fee. If you want to participate as a partner, if you have money to invest, you put up some money. We'll put up some money. It does take a little longer. I mean, most of the deals that we did last year, we did in 3-4 months. But I still have one property left over in Calumet City that, for past 9 months now, I'm hoping it will close before next Friday. But it took a long time to help those people for a lot of various reasons. And it was probably one of the hot properties in the best condition, but that's just the nature of investing. So, you know, if you want to be involved in that, that's fine. I mean, I have a partner in that, and we've had to wait 9 months before we're finally going to get paid. And what happens if you have to wait 9 months, you obviously make less money than if you can get it done in 3 months. So hopefully with that experience, we'll eliminate that in 2017. We are already beginning to work, or, you know, anticipate that there's going to be 1,000 leads by the end of April. But this list that I've given you, try to get a couple deals out of it. I mean, it's a very, the list was originally 600 leads. We whittled it down to 300, and there's a lot of potential deals to be had in there. I look forward to working with you. I thank you for your time. Have a beautiful day, and we will see you soon.